to guard it. I feel like preaching in here. He began to guard it. I lost my house, but I got my mind. Lost my job, but he got my mind. Anyway, the devil pricks, and wherever the devil approaches, he's guarding my mind. It's a military term. He that keepeth Israel neither slumbers nor sleeps. Get somebody high five for the third time and say, neighbor, don't make sense for you being up all night. You worrying about stuff. If God is up, let him handle it. All you got to do is give him glory and go to sleep. I feel like lifting him up. I feel like giving him the glory. He said you got to watch what you think. When things are going off, you got to watch how you think. Ain't no time to get a whole lot of gossip right through here. I don't need no gossip. What I need right now is whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are true. I feel like crying in here. But you can step over here. You can have the facts and still not have the truth. I feel like preaching. The 12 spies, they all had the facts, but only two of them had the truth. I need to think on some true stuff. I heard him when he said he sent in spies. Well, a spy sneaks in and a spy sneaks out, and you make sure you're not seen. Then how come the report says they looked at us like we were grasshoppers? You're a spy. You sneaked in and you snuck out. Did nobody see you? It's how you thought about yourself. Cause it don't matter how big the giants are. Those are the facts. But the truth is, the God I serve is more powerful than any giant. I'm thinking deliverance. I'm thinking no matter how bad it is, I ain't about to lose my mind. Can I preach like a silly? Get somebody high five for time number four and say, neighbor, don't lose your mind, cause you lose a woman. I feel like preaching. I'm not gonna lose my mind, cause I lost a woman. I'm gonna need my mind for the next one that's coming. I ain't gonna lose my mind, cause I lost a job. I'm gonna need my mind for the next job. I'm not gonna lose my mind, cause I lost a house. I'm gonna need my mind for the next house. I'm not gonna lose my mind, cause you lost a man. You better keep your mind for the next man. I refuse to go crazy or believe in a few things, cause God knows I can get things in return. But I refuse to lose my mind. I feel the Holy Ghost. I can do all things. Get somebody high five for the fifth time and say, neighbor, you can. You can. I can. We can. I praise him with a house, and I praise him in a sack. I praise him in a rose, and I praise him on the bus. I can do all things. I feel like preaching in here. I feel like lifting him up. I can praise him in pononos. I can praise him in flippers. I've learned how to be full. I've learned how to be hungry. I learned how to praise him with the money. But I know how to praise him broke. I know how to lift him up when I'm feeling good. But I can still give him glory when I'm feeling bad. I can. You can. We can. Do all things. Rich, poor, up, down. I can. Do all things through Christ with strength. I got left. You come out of high time for the seventh time, and the neighbor is soon repaired. It's soon repaired. Hold yourself. Hold your mind. Keep yourself from going crazy. Do not lose your integrity. You talk about God. You tell people about God. Now you're going through something. Stand up and let the devil know. I can't. In fact, I will. I will. I will. No suicide. African Americans are committing suicide at an increasingly alarming rate. Over the things? Don't talk to me for a minute here. You never lose your mind over no car. So you can't buy St. John Nick now. Amen. Ain't no sense you wrecking your home, driving your husband crazy over some stuff you can't get now. You can't frighten Lazarus with death. He already been there and done that. Amen. Y'all act like y'all ain't never been broke. Y'all been broke before. Y'all talk to me. Y'all sit down. I done got mad. I done got mad. The church, the cause of the house falling down was not the wind, was not the rain, was not the storm. The house fell down because it wasn't built on the right foundation. Amen. If it were built right, it might lose a roof, might lose some windows, some shutters, but all those things are replaceable. If your foundation is right, you can get through the financial storm without losing your integrity. I'm closing. You have a strength, first of all, you know nothing about. As a human being created by God, you have a strength you know nothing about. I'm going to stretch a little bit here now. Let's take a trip to Job. Now, what would it be like if I were going to the hospital and I went to the bed, somebody just awfully sick, and I leaned over and I said, now the reason you're sick like this, I just got a revelation. The Lord showed me why you're sick. The reason you're sick like this is because God and Satan had a little contest. They had a little thing going on, and God brought your name up. And just really in pain, just sick, real sick now. Now, what kind of comfort would that be? And, you know, the Lord just, you know, Satan and God had something going on real in heaven, and all that you're going through right now is because God and Satan. Got something going on. You're not self-righteous because God said he was righteous. He said there's no man like him, not in all the east. Alright? So now, that couldn't be any comfort, now could it? How would you feel about your God and your church? Amen. I mean, you told me to do right.